Good. My name is Zhang Kai. So now we're going to start our presentation for present our housekeeping robot.
That's good.
Housekeeping robot is designed in our project. Why you want to do this? Housekeeping robot was cleaning the house automatic. It already reduced the burden during cleaning house. In our design, two types of sensory are used. They are the IR sensor and the dust stream sensor. Moreover, PID control and the PLC control will be used to control our robots.
which competitor has participated. Now we're going to see the operation. So, how to let our robot to process this kind of function? So, our robot needs to contain the PID controller. Why PID controller is used? PID controller is used to control the direction of the servo motor when the dust particle is detected. As my partner, you mentioned just now, PID controller is used because it can reduce the steady state error and perform some of the boost and braking action on our system. In this, so the robot will move in a shorter time to the design direction to reduce the effect of disturbance such as the air friction force or any airflow or the prism obstacle, which might possible to change the output of the robot from the design position. Besides that, two types of sensor need to use. First is dust sensor. Dust sensor is used to detect the dust particle, while the IR sensor means infrared sensor were used to detect the presence of obstacle to avoid the collision between the motor and the obstacle. So our robot will not be spoiled during the collision. So now this is the simulation of our house cleaning robot. So this part is for the PID controller. This one is for the dust sensor. Five dust sensors are used in our robot. So the five sensor will be used to control the direction. Maybe the first sensor is used to turn 90 degrees left. And the third sensor is used to make the robot to move forward direction. So now this one I'm not going to more detail. So maybe I use driving to explain more. So about the simulation of Proteus, I'm not going to detail this. Now I just use to draw to let you to explain more about this. So this one is our robot. House cleaning robot. So there are five dust sensors will be connected in our robot. So we will label it sensor 1, sensor 2, 3, 4, and 5. When sensor 1 detects the dust particle, according to the input command, the robot will turn in 90 degrees left direction. So when sensor 1 and 2 detect the dust particle, it will turn about 45 degrees in left direction. So and so on. Sensor 3 is made the robot to move in forward direction. 4 is the right 45 degrees, and the 5 is the 90 degrees in right direction. So in this case, we need to know that there is two servo motors. So when you want to turn left, so means servo motor will be stopped. So the servo motor will still rotate, so you will make the robot to turn left. Just according to the output command for the sensor, the servo motor 1 and 2 will stop according to the condition. Now we're going to see the strategy simulation. About the servo motor for the infrared sensor. So when the infrared sensor, this one is for the infrared sensor. Infrared sensor is used to detect the obstacle, and when it detects any obstacle or hurdle in front of the motor, it will stop to prevent collision. So maybe the robot will change direction. So now we want to see motor 1 and 2. The motor 1 is on the right, and IR sensor 1 is placed at the left side of the motor, while the sensor 2 will place on the right side of the motor. So when sensor 1 is being detect anything, we assume the IR sensor 1 and sensor 2 didn't detect anything. So the motor 1 and 2 will rotate in the same direction to make the house cleaning robot to move in forward direction. Okay. This condition, when the sensor 2 detects the hurdle, so the motor, servo motor 2 will stop. So the robot will turn right. This is same as the concept of the dust particle. Almost same as the concept. Next. Now, when sensor 1 detects the hurdle, so it will produce the output signal to make the motor 2 stop, then the robot will turn left. This kind of function is to make the robot turn in the direction to prevent the collision with the hurdle and make sure the robot will continue to move around the place to make sure all of the place will be clean. Okay, that's all for me.
This is a design for our speed robot. It's open its view from the isometric view, this is from the view and the operation. Okay, so first this isometric view, this start button and stop button, and that's the screen release button and flexible bumper. This design is a circle design because it's easy to move actually. Okay, so these are from bottom view. This servo motor here too, and this dust sensor. We have the sensor and infrared sensor, and then the universal wheel, and then also we have a side brush and the rubber brush and the wheel brush. Okay, and then this operation is actually simple to understand, which is first when the robot detect the dust, so this side brush, we move and then we so that the dust we go inside the robot, and then this main brush and the rubber brush we rotate, and then we go to the dust bin. That's a simple to understand about the operation of this rusty robot. Okay, this actually the controller device was used in this robot, which is we have the input pin, the output pin. We have the external power supply. We can supply use battery actually. We also can connect to the computer use a cable, and then we have this microcontroller. This is ATmega 2328, and then we also have a reset button, and then also this actually is the Arduino Uno. This Arduino actually can do the variety task, and then the program we store in this microcontroller, and then actually we have a 5 sensor, so the coding that we code and we download to this microcontroller, and then the sensor we connect to the board, the input board, and the servo motor for the output board. So I think that's all about the